Good day, YouTube. This is just a bit of a quick comparison video between Pop! OS 20.10 on the left and Linux Mint 20.2 on the right. So getting into it. Now, start of all, a little bit of an apples to oranges video because they are running on different desktop environments. So Pop! OS chooses to use the GNOME desktop environment, which you might see there. And Cinnamon Mint uses its own in-house built Cinnamon desktop environment. But I'm a bit of a fan of both of them, but having a look here, so we go to the applications menu for, say, for instance, for the Pop! OS, if it chooses to load, and yep, there we go, great, and I like the way that they've designed this. It is probably important to mention in this part of the video that Pop! OS 20.10 is currently in beta release at the time of recording of this video, so something to bear in mind. This should be all set in stone there now, being a beta release. So yeah, I just like the look that it decides to go with. It's got a little a search launcher there, so you type in something to find what you want. So that's pretty cool there as well. I like that they've integrated the minimize button for the for terminals and all sorts of things there. It isn't actually there with a lot of GNOME desktop environments, and I hate that. I'm just like, I've got Windows everywhere and I can't you work with the workspaces that well, and I'm just really happy with that. So that's that there. On the right hand side, we've got the Cinnamon, so it's a nice little startup menu, as you can expect. They're both running with probably the exact same color of dark mode there, which is cool, but they do have all the apps, both of them, each that you would want. I'll mention that Pop! OS is actually based on Ubuntu, as is Linux Mint. The Linux Mint is based on the long-term service release, so generally you're working with older kernels and things like that there. The file manager is going to be a little bit similar, but not exactly the same, because we've got GNOME files on the left-hand side, which goes by many names, and then we've got the Cinnamon version, which is the Nemo, which Cinnamon uses. It really just goes hand in hand there. So mostly the same, just right click, open in terminal. That's all I want for out of a file manager these days. But hey, one's going with the blue colors, the other's going with the green tones there, and they're just keeping it in the family with the colors that they use, which is pretty cool. Although obviously that's all customizable too. Now we have the, let's see, the back end, or the, yeah, just under the hood. So kernel for Pop! OS is 5.15, which is expected. It's one of the latest and greatest. Whereas Linux Mint is running on the 5.4 kernel, so a little bit older. Something to bear in mind if you're going to use later and greater physical hardware. You do want the kernel to match there. And just lastly is the RAM usage on boot up. So nothing's really loaded in the background, save for the operating system itself. Pop! OS, being that it's running on GNOME, is using about 1.2 gigabytes of RAM on boot up. That will fluctuate, maybe down to 900, 1,000. That's the problem with GNOME. I'm not a big fan of it. Probably the heaviest desktop environment that I know of at the moment. Whereas Cinnamon, the in-house developed desktop environment for Linux Mint, is looking pretty good at about 800 megabytes of RAM on boot up. So what the winner that one is here. So thanks for watching, guys. Please leave a comment, subscribe, hit that like button, and I hope to see all of you guys there in the next one.